Hey guys, on this Adrian Graphics video, I have a training on graphic design. I want to show you guys how to master layout design, and that's what we're going to talk about. We're going to have some fun, we're going to get deep, we're going to talk about the 7 things in layout design that you need to know as a graphic designer if you want to take your work from amateur or rookie to pro. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. So as I've said many times, my goal is to help you become a better designer, not just in your graphic design skills, but as a business person and as an entrepreneur. Today's video is going to be specifically focused on training you on layout design. You may understand this, you may not, and there may be some things you can use for a refresher. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So today we're going to talk about the 7 rules that you need to take in consideration when you're doing any kind of design. I don't care if it's logo design, print design, web design, ad design, any of this type of design, you're going to need to apply these rules. And so as you continue to go through this training, I want you to take notes, get a pen and paper, because this is going to be really valuable if you've never done this before. So when it comes to graphic design, it applies to every area of graphic design, whether it's logo design, website design, social media design, flyer design, any kind of print design, and even signage on your buildings, on banners, on cars, whatever that is, you need to apply these principles in these specific areas. It applies to all graphic design. So the first rule is negative space, what a lot of designers know as white space. Leaving white open space is very important. You don't want to clutter up your designs. So I'm just going to read you the description of negative space so you have a deeper understanding. Negative space is specific areas that are open in your design that do not have any graphical elements or assets. It allows the design to breathe and helps it by separating the different sections and enhancing your hierarchy, which we're going to talk about at the end of this. This helps the viewer feel more at ease and makes the design look not as busy or cluttered. This is something that I do in a lot of my designs, and I'm going to show you some examples right now. You've got to use negative space in your design if you're cluttering up your designs with so many elements and so many things and fonts and images and graphics and photos. Your design is going to look cluttered, it's going to look busy, and people are going to have a hard time really getting the message. So this is the first one. You can see here the sycamore tree, right? It actually has a broken plate. This is probably for a movie or some sort of an event, and the broken plate actually forms a tree. And I can guarantee you this probably looks a lot like a sycamore tree. This next one here is a logo design. This is one of my all-time favorite logo designs. It's called Spartan Golf Club. And if you look carefully here, you can see not just the power of him doing the swing, but it actually makes the helmet. And then if you look a little closer here, here's the eye, here's the nose, here's the mouth. And you can see this actually makes a Spartan helmet with a face. Really neat. And you also have the golfer here. This is one of the best negative space designs and logo designs I've ever seen. And then if you look at this last one here, the word says shift. But you'll notice here, this is a dark black or dark gray lettering here. All the letters here are dark black and gray, except for this H. And the H is made by the arrows. That's all it took, is just butting this up on the left, on the right, butting this up on the left. And it actually, you can see here inside of this negative space, you have that H. So this is a really good example of using negative space and actually creating a really cool logo design, something that's very unique with arrows. I've actually done something very similar for a credit repair company where we did the same kind of concept, and I made an H. I did the arrows top and bottom like that. The second rule of layout design is proximity. There is a lot of power in proximity, not just in your personal life and within your business, but also in doing design. Proximity is one of my favorite words. It's a really powerful word, but it also applies to your graphic design skills and actually elevating your graphic design abilities. So let me just read you what is proximity. Linking design elements that have a relationship or are grouped together. Aspects that don't have a relationship should not be linked together. If used correctly, proximity will help you structure your design, and it indicates to the users visual cues and information. And you're going to use graphical elements that should be in the same style. So a lot of the times, using the same style for those elements to link them together. So you use 2 fonts in one section, and you might use 2 fonts in a different section for elements that need to be separated, or you use different colors. So creating things and putting things in proximity is really important, and I'll show you a quick example of that. So here's a very good example you can see here on my screen. Proximity guides attention. You can see here all of the call to action buttons are here in orange. The descriptions are here in black. The text boxes are here in gray. And you have this navigation. This is kind of an example of a web page design or an ad design. This is a good example. You can see things are linked and they have proximity. These are the headlines. So actually grouping things together is very, very important of what, you know, your headlines, your subheadlines, your images, your call to action buttons. You want to make sure that you use proximity correctly in all of your design work. Another good example, and this is a website that we created, is proximity. So obviously we want to link the logo along with the description up here together. We wanted to link the login and kind of a call to action to either join our network or log in. Those two were linked together. You can see here the navigation is inside of a bar and they all have a similar font. And these are all part of proximity. You have our main headline, why pay more when you can pay less? And then right here you have the subheadline. At NextGen Septics, we believe that you deserve the best service, value, and price for your septic system needs. These are together. If this paragraph was down here at the bottom, it wouldn't have the same power. So we're linking these elements together to give that proximity more power. Another good example is our website. So you can see here, we have all of our navigation and everything here linked at the top. Our phone number is in red over to the right, which matches our logo, which is also a call to action, which matches this call to action. And then we have this main paragraph, which is in proximity with who we are as a company. And then we have the proximity where this is separated. This doesn't have anything to do with it, so putting it behind it or putting it closer to it, we have it perfectly spaced where it kind of separates and is standing on its own, but it's also within the proximity of this hero shot. So it's all kind of linked together in this blue background and just flows very, very nicely. The third rule of layout design is repetition. This is something that I had just naturally that I picked up at a really young age, and I'll just read you this description real quick. Repetition is the key elements of a layout design, but also a graphic design in general. It gives design a consistent theme, look, and feel. And you do that by using color palettes, similar shapes, and patterns all throughout the design. This is something, and you can even use similar fonts, typography, colors, shapes, patterns. These are all important pieces to repetition that you're gonna use in your design. So using repetition is gonna help that design become more consistent, the look and feel, the fonts. I always tell people as a general rule, when you're doing repetition and you're using the same fonts, you wanna use more than just one font, but you don't wanna use more than two. That's just my general rule. Occasionally you can use a third, but for the most part, you wanna use two fonts in each design, because if you use too many, it's gonna become cluttered looking and it's just not gonna turn out as well as you want it to. So let me show you a quick example of that. So you can see here, this graphic on the left, they took one piece of pizza, one design element, and they repeated it and changed it. They changed the size, they changed the direction, they rotated it, they moved it in different areas, but this repetition, nobody's thinking that that's the same exact pizza, but if you look closely, you'll notice it has the little half slice here, has a little half slice. It's all the same image. It's one element that was repeated across the design that really gives that repetition and that feel of the design. It really makes it unique and special. And so using repetition like this pizza idea to really create that layout is very helpful. And you can see the same thing over here with the pencil. This is the same pencil, but it's rotated and flipped and probably even sized a little bit in some of these to really give this cool layout design. And you can see here, this overall graphic is really good. It uses two different fonts. So you have this font and this font. It uses two different colors and actually has a little bit of a shade, which is really nice. So it's got a good color palette. And then it has a good hierarchy. The way they laid this out is really, really well done. It incorporates a lot of what we've talked about so far. The third rule of layout design is contrast. I love contrast. Contrast is one of my favorite pieces of design, whether you're using black and red or black and white or red and white. Using contrasting colors is a really, really important thing that you need to do in your designs, because if you use a light red and a little bit darker of a red on a background, it's not gonna stand out. So having more contrast. Now, one thing I will tell you that's really important before I read this description is a lot of people will get into the trap where they'll do black and white designs, and those designs don't really have a whole lot of personality. And so when you're using contrast, sometimes instead of just using a straight black, you can use a gray. So it's not so harsh on the eye. So sometimes you can go a little bit too far with the contrast with just a harsh black and just a plain white. That's just a little rudimentary, a little boring. But if you use a little bit lighter of a black, like a light black or a dark gray, you can give it a better feel and you still have plenty of that contrast. So don't take it to the extreme. You don't need to do black and white or red, a bright, bright neon red and a bright, bright neon yellow. You gotta be careful with the contrast. So I just wanna preface it with that. It's really important, but let me go ahead and read you this description. So contrast is used to create a focal point and give certain elements more weight than others, using two elements that are uniquely different but complementary. Contrast can be achieved with fonts, colors, shapes, and sizes, and it's really great for grabbing attention and directing the eye. That's what I use contrast more than anything, is to really direct the eye. The things that are the most important on that design, whether it's a flyer, an ad, I'll typically make a more vibrant, brighter color. And the things that are not as important, like a description or a subheadline, I'll make a lighter color, something that doesn't need to be so pronounced and so red. But the attention getters, the main things that are the hook, like your hook statement or the intention getter, I'll make those things brighter, bigger, and more pronounced and more prominent. Here's another example of very, very good contrast. So you can see here, they didn't use a solid black. They actually used a little bit lighter of a black along with the white, and then they used the blue. So these two are fairly contrasting, but if you were to put this color text on top of this background, that wouldn't contrast very well, and it wouldn't look very good, would it? So you wanna make sure that you're using really, really good elements and really good contrast, and you're not going over the top. This poster design here for Marvin Berry's Starlighters is beautiful. The contrast is really well done. The black to the lighter green to the purple, these are all really, really good contrasting colors, so it just really works very well. And there's a tool within Adobe Illustrator and even with Adobe Photoshop that you can utilize to actually get some better contrast. Or if you really need to, you can use the Peloton. It's a Peloton color palette. You just Google that, it'll come up for you, and it'll show you the colors that you should use. And then again, you wanna use not just contrasting colors, but contrasting fonts. So you can see here, there's this Yellowtail font, and it pairs very well with Montserrat. You got the Northwester font, and it pairs very well with the Arvo Italic. You got the League Gothic, which is a really cool font. I've always liked this one, that pairs really well with Georgia. This is a serif and a sans serif font. You can actually do that. I always tell people to be very careful of pairing fonts that are serif and sans serifs, because it can look really cheesy and bad, but they've done a pretty good job pairing these together. And then you have the Abril Fat Face and the Lado. These two pair together really well. So you wanna use contrasting fonts as well to highlight headlines and subheadlines. This is gonna really make your designs a lot better. The fifth rule for layout design is alignment. Alignment is really key. I use alignment in every project, and I'm kind of an OCD person about alignment. I think that's why a lot of people like my designs, is I wanna make sure that everything is very well aligned and organized. It just makes the designs look cleaner, more professional and polished. And even the slightest little variance of that alignment, if your text is a little far off to the left or is a little bit too big off to the left, can make a big difference in that design, the smallest things, and they add up. So let me just read you the description that I wrote here for alignment. One of the most important rules of design, poor alignment can make a design look amateur. Text, images, and design elements should be aligned to make the design piece look polished and not cluttered and confusing. If you have all these different misaligned, huge text for a subheadline and a small text for the headline, and they're off or shifted off to the left or off to the right or in a random spot, it's gonna make it look unpolished and unprofessional. It's gonna make your designs look amateur. And that's not what I want. I want your guys' designs to look as great as possible. So it's really important that you really align the objects within your design. If you have a photo above a headline, make sure it's the same width as that text right above it. It's gonna make it look really clean. I do this a lot. You'll notice this in my design work. So now I just wanna show you a few examples of that. So here is good layout design, or good alignment, and bad alignment. As you can see on my screen here, there's even some guides, and it shows you where everything's lined up. You can tell the garden concerts, it's lined up with the description, and even the sub description, whether that's a call to action or a website address or a phone number, whatever that is also aligned. And you have some nice, clean, good white space all the way around this. And you can see here, this flower is aligned very beautifully. Now let's look at this terrible design. Same graphical elements in the design, but you got this random text right here. The text goes outside of the guides. I always encourage people to use guides when they're doing the alignment. If you're not using your guides, you need to start using those in Photoshop and Illustrator, whatever program you're using, and use your guides to align things. Give yourself margins all the way around the design so you have some good space, what they call bleeds. This is really important, but seeing how this is not aligned, you got these two that are aligned, and then this text doesn't really kind of fit this area very well. You got the all kind of the brushes and the flowers that aren't really sized very well. This description isn't aligned from this one. It just looks terrible. So you really need to focus on making sure that all of your design elements are aligned with each other and that they're equally balanced. This design has a much better balance and a much better flow, and it's broken up. You can see here, you got this nice little kind of little secondary line, but this is your main hook. This is where you wanna draw the eyes first, and then it'll go to here, and then they'll probably look up in here first. So this is not as important as the main headline, which is the garden concerts. So just make sure that all of your stuff is really well aligned. The sixth rule is focal point. Focal point goes a lot with alignment and hierarchy, which we're gonna talk about next, but your focal point is what is the main focus point of the design? What is the objective of the piece? A lot of people don't think about this when it comes to graphic design. What is the goal? What is it that you want? You want them to visit your website? You want them to take that flyer and turn it in? Is it a coupon? Is it an ad that you want them to click on? You need to have a focal point for every single design. And if you don't have a focal point, then they're not gonna know what to focus on, what to look on, where to start first. So making sure that you have one element first that guides them there, and that's like your main hook. It's gonna be your main point that you want them to start at, that's gonna get them to go, oh wow, and then wanna read more. So make sure you have a focal point. This is used to lure the viewer into the design and on the elements that are the most important and in the correct order as well. It helps the viewer start their journey and is a hot spot to grab their attention. Great focal points are elements that are very recognizable, like people, shapes, photos, or even stylized photography. In a lot of the designs and a lot of the research and just trial and error and things that I've done over the years, especially doing nightlife design, I have used a lot of people in my designs because that is the most recognizable. The human being and people, like hands or fingers or especially eyes, are the most recognizable objects on the planet. People notice them more than anything. And so if you use people in your design, or you use a hand, or you use some sort of human element, it's very attractive and it really draws in the eye. So if you're gonna put a hand or an eye, make sure that that eye or that visual element or shape or whatever it is next to your main focal point of text as well. And maybe your focal point is the text and it's not some sort of graphical element, but you can use graphical elements to draw the eye to the main point that you want to use. And that's really important to create a really great layout design. The seventh and the last rule of layout design is hierarchy. Visual hierarchy is used to rank design elements and influence in the order that you want the user to view them. By using principles like contrast, scale, balance, and more, you can help establish each of the elements in the rightful place and help those most important elements stand out. It's part of your information architecture, which I want you to do some research on, and I'm probably gonna make a video on here pretty soon. And it also helps the users navigate through the design easier. So this can apply to your website design, this can apply to a logo design, this can apply to an ad. Having hierarchy in your design is a big area that I see a lot of people struggle in. They have some sort of sub headline or some sort of little paragraph off to the bottom that's like bright red and it's super huge at the bottom because they really want to draw people in, like a website address, before they've even given a person a reason to even look at the website address. So hierarchy is a really important piece of your design work. You need to make sure that you're taking them through a journey. It's an experience, a user experience. So hierarchy is going to give them that user experience if it's done right. And so making sure that your main hook, the main point that's gonna actually give them some sort of value or benefits and make them wanna continue to read more, and then taking them onto the next most important thing. And I do that by, one, lumping things together, making them the right color, using some visual elements to draw the eye. If you're gonna do a coupon, that's probably gonna be the more on the bottom side of your design, or off to the left or to the right, and you're gonna lump that into some sort of graphical element that's gonna draw people to that coupon to attract them to say, oh, a deal or a sale or a price or some sort of saving. So this is a really big deal. This is a great opportunity for you to learn how to better make layouts on websites, graphics, print, signage, whatever. Here's a couple good examples of hierarchy. You can look at these two business cards and you can see a dramatic difference between the left one to the right one. This is an example of terrible hierarchy. In fact, there's not really any hierarchy. The only hierarchy there is this photo. And so that photo is so huge in comparison to all the rest of the text. This text is a little bit bigger than this, but this hierarchy is just very poorly done. Now you look at over here and it really has a lot of alignment. You can see it lines up right here around the edges very well. If I were to actually do this, I probably would have blown this up a little bit bigger and matched up this text with the website width, and made the same thing with the phone number and the same thing with the website. I would have had this all be aligned so that it looks like a nice clean text block. So this one actually isn't perfect, but it's a lot better hierarchy than this one. Another couple examples that I wanted to show you is actually making the hierarchy work rationally for somebody's brain. If you have a whale, like you can see here on this left-hand side, and the person's the same size as the whale, it just doesn't work. You gotta make it actually visually higher, have the visual hierarchy apply to the elements. A whale is gonna be a lot bigger than the scuba diver, right? So make sure that you do that. Same thing with this design here. You can see the before and after, making the moon almost the same size as the astronaut versus the perspective. So using perspective is gonna be really important with that hierarchy as well. And then you can see here, this design element, the main draw that the person wants in this design to suit is better thinking. The second thing that they want them to is with an additional understanding that comes from obsessive attention to detail, our outstanding creativity brings you effective, bespoke, perfectly designed results. And then obviously the second thing here, they want them to continue to scroll, is step one. And they have this big element of this pencil that draws the eye in here. It almost is like an arrow that kind of points up to the better thinking. This almost kind of points to this. So it's kind of really well aligned. Everything is evenly spaced. I think this is going a little bit outside. It's actually slightly off, but for the most part, this is a really, really clean design. What I don't like about this design, and I'll just give you some feedback on this, is look how big this text is, and then look how small this is. I really feel like they could have brought this out a little bit further and made this a little bit bigger and really made this design look even better than it is here. But for the most part, this is a really good design and a good example of hierarchy. So this is your opportunity for Q&A. If you have any questions about anything that I just said, I want to hear from you. What was your most valuable takeaway from this? What did you know? What did you learn? What was something that you learned from this video that you can actually give some feedback here? I want to hear from you. And if you have a question about something or you need more information, please drop it down there. And I am really good at responding to every single comment, as you probably know. I will get back to you and I will do my best to answer any of your questions. My goal is to help you become the best that you possibly can and get you breakthrough in your career, on a personal, on a financial level, and even on a spiritual level. So thank you guys so much for watching today. I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. I'm Adrian Boisel. And as always, keep looking up.